This is going to be the third video about set operations and Venn diagrams. And what I want to do in this video is start with a Venn diagram and find the set operations that would have created that diagram. So here's the first diagram I have. I've got my universal set, that's the rectangle, and inside there I've got sets A and B, and they overlap. And A and B are completely shaded except for the overlap. Now, we can take that description and use that to figure out the operations that made that picture. So, A and B are completely shaded. Let's start with that part of the phrase. Well, if A and B are completely shaded, that would be the union of A and B. So, I'm going to write A union B in parentheses. And then I said, except for the overlap. Well, except for makes it seem like I want to take something away from it. So I'll put in my minus sign for the relative complement. And then I want to take away the area that's in the overlap. Well, the area that's in the overlap is the intersection of A and B. So I'm going to take away A intersect B. And that will get us to this Venn diagram. Now, very often there's more than one way to create a specific Venn diagram. Here's another way we could have done it. I could have started just thinking about the circle that I have for set A. And I could say, oh, that circle is shaded in completely except for the part that's also in B. So that would mean I would have an A minus the part that's in B. And I could also think about this about set B and say set B is completely shaded except for the part that's in A. So that would mean I would have a B minus the part that's in A. And since I want both of those shaded parts of A and B, I would put a union sign between the two of them. Okay? And there may be more ways than that to do this. You could experiment and see what else you could find. Okay, here's another one. Here, once again, I have two overlapping sets, A and B, inside the universal set. And this time what I've got is everything outside of those two sets is shaded, and the overlap of A and B is shaded. So let's take that description and see if we can find a way to figure out the set operations. So everything outside of A and B is shaded. That means if I take the union of A and B, and I took the complement of that, it would give me everything that is outside of the union of A and B. So that's going to shade everything outside of those two circles. Then I also want to shade in the overlap between A and B. Okay, so since I also want that, I'll put in a union sign. And then for my second set of parentheses, I'm going to have A intersect B. Okay, so I'm getting the area outside the circles by using a complement of A union B. I'm getting the overlap between the two circles by using the intersection of A and B. And I'm putting the union sign between those two, so I get both of those areas. Okay, here's one more. Here I've got three circles, A, B, and C, and they all overlap. And what I've got shaded in here looks like it would be the intersection of A and B, as well as the intersection of A and C, except that I'm not shading in the part right in the middle there, the part that would also contain part of the intersection of B and C. So let's see how we can do this. Let's start with the intersection of A and B. So that's going to be A intersect B. And I also would like the intersection of A and C. So I'm going to put a union sign, and then in parentheses I'll have the intersection of A and C. Now if I leave it like that, those two intersections will be connected. But I've got that place right in the middle of these three circles, that little triangle area. What I could do is I could take away anything that's in the intersection of B and C of these two sets here, and that would get rid of that triangle. So I'll put in a minus sign, and I'm going to take away anything that's in the intersection of B and C. Okay? So I hope you get the idea about how to do these things. Very often, a simple thing to do is just kind of describe it to yourself and see if that description helps you come up with the set operations that you're going to need. Okay, that's it. Take care, and I'll see you next time.